Amy Antony began her art career in 1990 as a contemporary artist. She attended Sarah Lawrence College and then the Rhode Island College of Design. In 1998, Janie won the MacArthur Fellow Award, and in 2011, she won the Guggenheim Fellow Award. Antony stands out from the crowd in the art community due to her materials, personalization, and creativity. One of the reasons Janie is a unique artist in the contemporary community is her choice of materials. According to Janie Antony by Wide Walls, Janie Antony is a bohemian contemporary artist who works with different materials such as soap, lard, and chocolate. This quote highlights some of Janie's material preferences, which are clearly much different than the norm. The following quote will also go into depth on Janie's choice in materials. According to Janie Antony by Luring Augustine, Antony is known for her unusual processes by using her body as both a tool and a source of meaning within the conceptual framework of her practice. Antony's early methods involve transforming unique materials such as chocolate and soap through habitual everyday processes like bathing, eating, and sleeping to create sculptural works and installations. As stated, Janie uses her materials as a way to stand out and be different, but to also provide a deeper meaning to her art, as well as an experience for her audience. Each piece of Janie's art has a different meaning and idea, but there is a common theme throughout all of her works. It is the induction of emotion and the blending of performance and sculpture. According to Janie Antony by Stuart Hrodner from Bomb Magazine, if I don't have an experience with the object, how can I hope that the viewer will have an experience with the object? I start from that place. Making something is like a fight. I start out with an idea of what I want it to be, and I try to impose it on the material. This quote shows that Antony tries to invoke emotions from her audience by creating an experience for them from an experience she had herself. Also, according to Milagros, Janie Antony by Art 21, Janie Antony's work blurs the distinction between performance art and sculpture, transforming everyday activities such as eating, bathing, and sleeping into ways of making art. Antony's primary tool for making the sculpture has always been her own body. Antony's goal is to blend performance and sculpture while using a new medium, or even her body, to create a connection to the art viewers. Although most of Antony's works are very well put together and well known, she has a few pieces that stand out more than the others. According to Mom and Dad, Janie Antony, by Startle, in Mom and Dad, though, Antony uses her parents as sculptural material, using prosthetics and stage makeup to transform her mother and father into each other. True, Antony could have used herself, a la Cindy Sherman. She could have gone on Craigslist and asked strangers to be her models. But the fact that she knows her parents so well, she makes the effort to change one into the other far more challenging. Probably even more challenging than learning to tightrope, a feat Antony calls rope meditation. Janie's piece titled Mom and Dad is a well-known piece due to its depth. At first glance, Mom and Dad looks like an ordinary portrait of two people. When you dive deeper into this piece, you realize its true beauty and creativity. This piece also shows Antony's value with meaning and depth of her pieces. She chose the harder route while creating this piece just to ensure her ideas were clear and concise to her audience. According to About Janie Antony by Immaculate Conception, Na comprises two 600-pound cubes, one of chocolate and the other of lard, in a three-paneled mirrored cosmetic display case. Using her mouth as a tool, Antony nibbled the corners of both cubes, leaving visible teeth marks in the material. The chocolate fragments blended with spit were melted down and cast into 27 heart-shaped packages for chocolates, while the lard residue was combined with wax and bright red pigment to create 135 tubes of lipstick. This quote goes further into detail on Antony's piece titled Gnaw. Gnaw is a piece in which Antony used her teeth to carve into hundreds of pounds of chocolate and lard. This piece is something very special just due to the fact of its materials and the methods Antony used to create it. In another quote, taken from other works by Janie Antony, written by SFMOMA, Lick and Lather is a sculpture done by Janie Antony, which was created in 1993 to 94. This piece features two self-portrait busts, one chocolate and one soap. Lick and Lather is a piece that Janie created by using her body yet again to create two stunning works within one piece. Her idea when creating this piece is that she would feed herself with herself and wash herself with herself. This is a process that is strictly unique to Janie, and she will continue to be known for her individuality in the art community. Janie Antony has many identifying qualities of her artworks due to her uniqueness. According to Janie Antony, Loving Care and Lick and Lather by Contemporary Art, she is known for her unusual processes. Her body is both her tool for making and the source from which her meaning arises. Antony's early works transformed materials like chocolate and soap and used everyday activities like bathing, eating, and sleeping as sculptural processes. She carefully articulates her relationship to the world, giving rise to emotional states that are felt in and through the senses. And each piece, no matter the medium or image, it conveyed physicality speaks directly to the viewer's body. Both Loving Care and Lick and Lather are pieces that are highly unique and controversial to some, which is a part of Janie's style. All of Janie's pieces feature some personal touch from Janie herself, whether that be an emotional connection or a physical one. The most interesting and notable fact about Janie Antony's art is that she utilizes her body when creating a new piece. According to Janie Antony by Wide Walls, she uses her body as a tool to create art. She's using her tongue, eyelashes, and hair as replacements for pencils, chisels, and brushes in the process of making her pieces. One of the most interesting facts about Janie, as stated, is that she uses some part of her body in every piece of art she creates. For example, in her piece titled Na, Janie used her mouth to carve and shape pounds of chocolate and lard into art. In another piece done by Antony titled Loving Care, Janie used her own hair to mop a floor with hair dye. This just shows how dedicated Antony is to her audience experience and emotion when they are viewing her artworks. In her early career, Janie was creating pieces that were outlandish, excessive, but also brilliant. As time went on, Antony's artworks began to calm down. Her pieces were still brilliant, but not as controversial as they once were. Everyone eventually will mature within their lifetime, and when Janie matured, it affected her art in an interesting way. While she was still creating pieces that were different and unique, it seemed as if she had just fine-tuned her true self. All in all, Janie Antony is a well-known contemporary artist who has many traits that set her apart from the normal group. Janie is a unique artist who values the audience's experience as well as her individuality while creating new masterpieces and the ability to be creative.